In this how-to video, I'm going to show you how to color fill the roll marks on your AR-15 lower receiver. And we're going to do that on a 80% lower that I have here that's unfinished. This is an 80% lower that's available from a company called 80% Lowers. Their website is 80-lower.com. I will put the information in the description of the video if you want to purchase one of these for yourself. Now, 80% Lowers don't have much in the way of roll marks on them at all. There's no logos, no serial numbers, state of where it came from, nothing like that. This particular one, the only roll marks on it are the fire and the safe right here on one side. And today we're going to color the fire roll marks in red and the safe in white. And before we get started on this, I wanted to talk about what you need to do this project. Some of these items are optional, but I strongly recommend that you have pretty much everything that I talk about here, and I'll explain the reasoning why. First off, we're going to start with what's over on the left here, so excuse my mess on my workbench. We've got a bottle of 70% isopropyl alcohol here. This is used basically to clean any contaminants from the roll mark area. There are multiple different types of cleaners you can use. Isopropyl alcohol is a safe cleaner that's not going to cause any issues with the finish on your lower receiver. It is sufficient to remove oil and grease and any other contaminants that might be on your lower receiver. If you decide to color fill on a lower receiver that you've been using for a while and it's been oiled and so on and so on, the isopropyl alcohol may not be appropriate for that type of cleansing, and you might want to look at a wax and grease remover. So moving on from the isopropyl alcohol, we're going to need two colors of paint, a red and a white, obviously. I recommend gloss red and gloss white. I further recommend that these would be paint made by a company called Testors. These are enamel paints, and they're model paints. These work very well for this particular purpose, and they have a lot of color to them. Now, one of the reasons I highly recommend these particular paints over anything else is mainly due to the red. You can use fingernail polish, which I have back here. I have a couple of bottles of fingernail polish. Now, the biggest problem with fingernail polish is that the red does not have a lot of pigment in it. And you don't have the luxury of being able to apply multiple coats of fingernail polish to your lower receiver to get a nice bright red finish. These just don't have the pigment. They're easy to work with, they're relatively inexpensive, but fingernail polish normally costs more than the Testors. So from a price point perspective, the Testors is the cheaper alternative. It's the better alternative. Yeah, the longevity is better with the Testors and so on. So I don't recommend the fingernail polish. I have used fingernail polish extensively. I've also used crayon methods for color filling, and I've color filled thousands of items. So the Testors is definitely the best one I've found so far. Now for cleanup, what we're going to be looking at, we're going to be looking at two types of cleanup liquid. The first is a non-acetone nail polish remover, and the second is actually the Testors brand thinner. The primary cleanup that you're going to be doing after your color fill, you're going to want to use the non-acetone nail polish remover. This is a very weak thinner. I guess that's the easiest thing I can say. It takes a while to remove Testors enamel paint using non-acetone nail polish remover. and that's what you want. The tester's thinner works very, very well. It's very efficient. So efficient, you'll probably end up removing the paint from your roll marks. This is primarily to clean your brush, if you're using a brush, or doing final touch-up work on your color fill. You use this very sparingly. It's very powerful. It dissolves tester's paint way too fast. And so we'll talk about how I utilize this, aside from cleaning the brushes, a little later. Now, for application of the paint, you've got several options. You can use a very, very fine-tipped brush, very small. You could use a needle. You could use a syringe that has had the end chopped off, a dull syringe that's has a very thin point on it. Not sharp, but very, very thin in diameter. And it isn't so you can suck paint up into a syringe. It's you're using it as a tool. You're dipping the end of it into the paint, and then you're filling the roll marks using the syringe. So the body of the syringe is basically something that you would hold on to as you fill in the roll marks. You could, like I mentioned, you could use a needle. There's anything that's really small that you can hold in your hand for dipping of the paint. What I'm going to demonstrate is I've got some small tester's brushes here. They call these micro brushes. These are relatively inexpensive. There's 10 of them in a package. And what I've done is I more or less, and you probably can't see that, but what I've done is cut off virtually all of the bristles. So there's very few bristles on the end of this. You don't need a lot of bristles for this particular task. So that's what I'm going to use for this. After the final cleanup, you're going to need some cotton swabs. Now, I have two types of cotton swabs here. This generic Kroger brand right here, or Q-tips if you want to refer to them as that, relatively inexpensive. The only thing I would say is try to pick a cotton swab that doesn't have a lot of little cotton strands coming off the end that can get into your project. Some of the extremely cheap ones, like these plastic ones, these plastic shafted ones, which I get from the dollar store, you get like $375 for a dollar or something like that. They're a bit fuzzy. So even the actual brand Q-tip, they're a little bit more fuzzy than I care for. So it's kind of hit and miss on what you can get your hands on. But any drug type store, CVS, Walgreens, should have everything that you need. Now these cotton swabs, the ones I'm holding here, these are going to be used for the majority of your cleanup. So keep that in mind. Now the other cotton swab that I use, which these are substantially more expensive. These are a couple of dollars for like 80. These are called Swispers. They're dual-tipped applicators. You can get these in the drugstores. They're in the makeup department. So if you go into where the women's makeup is, you can find these in there. And the reason I like these is, let's find one that hasn't been used. They have a very fine tip on them. So for doing extreme cleanup work where you need precision, this nice little sharp tip, it's not sharp like it's going to cut you, but it's very sharp and it's very detailed. So you can dip this in some cleaner and you can work into some very tight areas with these. So you use these sparingly where in situations where the regular Q-tip won't reach or it's too much. Also, what we have, what I use is these are magnifying type glasses, and you can buy these also in drugstores, Walmart, CVS, where have you, anywhere from like 1.5 power up to 4 or 5 power. These happen to be 10 power. These are provide a lot of magnification. Now, you could use a magnifying glass. If you had a magnifying glass that was on a stand, that would work. You could use a jeweler's loop as well, anything that provides you hands-free magnification. This is what I use so I can see the fine details, make sure that I'm getting paint exactly where I need to get paint. I don't want to be slopping paint all over the lower receiver because that just requires more cleanup work after the fact. Again, this is optional. If you have 20/20 vision and you can see these really small roll marks, you don't really need magnification glasses, but I like to have them. So that's pretty much what we're going to use for doing the color fill on this lower receiver. I also recommend that your work area and the environment that you're working in is room temperature, 60 to 75 degrees, give or take. Paint flows much better. It dries better when it's in a warm environment. So now that we've covered all of the items that we need, let's get going with prepping this lower receiver and getting some paint on it. Okay, our first step here is we want to clean our roll mark area. We're going to use some of our Q-tips and we're going to use some isopropyl rubbing alcohol. I actually have it in this little dispenser device here. You can pick these up. I got these from the dollar store for a dollar. I do believe these are designed to dispense some sort of liquid for makeup removal. There's a little a little circular tray right here that you could use a cotton ball and put on there and push down, and it pumps up fluid and fills this little area. I find these real handy for the isopropyl rubbing alcohol. I can just push down on it and fill this little area up with some alcohol and dip my Q-tip in it and then go ahead and clean. So we're basically going to try and just clean up the roll mark areas and remove any contaminants, oils, anything left over from the manufacturing process or handling, oils if you happen to be doing this on a lower receiver that's been used and you've on a firearm and you've oiled your firearm, you're going to have oil residue. So this is all we're doing, is basically just trying to make sure that there's no contaminants. And if there are contaminants left over, you'll probably notice that right away as you go to apply some paint and try to remove it. The paint is could develop air bubbles. It could react with the contaminants to where it won't actually cover that particular area. So, and if that's the case, you can just go in and remove the paint with some of the remover, whether it's the thinner or the non-acetone nail polish remover, and get back and start all over again, clean it thoroughly. Now, one of the other things I like to have on hand, depending upon what I happen to be using here, is a toothbrush. And I may use a toothbrush to make sure that none of those little cotton hairs are floating around or they've gotten stuck on the surface and are going to get mixed up in the paint. So you could probably just use a used toothbrush. I use a new toothbrush because I don't want to take a toothbrush and introduce any other additional contaminants into the project. And you want to make sure that your surface is completely dry from the rubbing alcohol. Rubbing alcohol evaporates pretty quickly, so you don't have to wait very long with the rubbing alcohol. We're going to do the red first. What I normally do with my paints also is I don't store these in my workshop, because my workshop is cold most of the time, so I keep these actually inside and I keep them at room temperature. And try to make sure my workshop is heated up properly before I start a project like this. So you want to shake up your paint and then stir it up a bit. For stirring, you could take a what I like to do is I'll take a Q-tip and I'll cut the end off of it, and I'll use that as a stirring stick. So we'll make sure that the paint has been shaken a bit and then stirred up, and then we should be ready to go. Okay, so for this particular phase of the paint application, I've actually kind of tilted the lower receiver up so you can kind of watch what I'm doing. If you're going to do this at home, you probably want to keep this flat so you don't get any have any issues with the paint running or anything of that nature. I don't think that's going to happen in this particular instance. So we have the little brush that I mentioned, which I cut down most of the bristles off of, and we're just going to start with dipping, not a large amount. We're talking just a little bit on the tip. And of course, if my fat head gets in the video, I apologize for that, because I do have to try and work on this while I make the video. Now I'm only going to do a couple of letters because this can be rather time consuming, and I know it's as exciting as watching paint dry, but I want you to be able to get an idea of how I'm going about doing this. Because these bristles are so small and I'm just dipping the very end of the bristles in, I'm able to, for the most part, fill up the roll marks. The goal with this first pass is not to completely fill up the roll marks. I'm trying to do them about halfway, give or take. It's hard to tell for sure, because I'm going to apply two coats, and of course you will get some paint outside of the roll marks on the lower receiver, and that's okay. That's what our non-acetone nail polish is for cleanup after the fact. So we've got the F done. I'm going to do the I. The less paint you have on the outside of your lower receiver, the less cleanup work. Okay, so I'm going to do the rest of these, rest of the fire off camera, and we'll be back. All right, we've got the fire filled in. Let's see if the camera wants to cooperate. There we go. You can kind of see what that looks like. I am very precise with putting the paint down. So there's a very minimal amount of paint on the outside of the roll marks. At this stage, what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean my brush. If you are so inclined, since if you do buy these same brushes, there's 10 in a package, you could have one dedicated for each color. I'm going to go ahead and clean this one and reuse it for the white, and we'll proceed on and do the safe. All right, we're ready to do the white. And again, I'm only going to do a couple of letters, and I'll do the rest off camera. I could be way more precise if I was holding this with both of my hands right up close to my magnified glasses, but I'm actually sitting at an angle, so this isn't as precise as I possibly could be. Alright, I'm going to do the rest off camera. Alright, that takes care of the safe roll marks. There we go. Now, at this juncture, what I normally do is I will let this dry for 30 to 45 minutes, and then I'll go back in and I'll put another light coat. Two light coats are preferable to one heavy coat, so keep that in mind. After I apply the second light coat, I'm going to let this dry for 24 hours. Now, I know that number is kind of a subjective number. Basically, I'll come back the next day and I will start with the removal of the excess paint. You don't want to rush the removal. The paint on the lower receiver should be very dry, very hardened. If you start this process with the paint still somewhat soft, not fully cured, it's going to smear all over the place and create a large mess, and you definitely don't want that. So give it 24 hours. That's erring on the extreme side of caution, but give it 24 hours before you come back and try to remove the excess paint. So at this point, I'm not going to show you the application of a secondary coat because it's the same as the first one. What I'm going to do is apply the second coat, let it dry for 24 hours, and we're going to come back and we're going to proceed on to the next step, which is cleaning up the lower receiver of the excess paint. Now that our paint has had plenty of time to cure, we're going to start the process of removing the excess paint on the lower receiver. We're going to be using our non-acetone nail polish remover, and we're going to be using our Q-tips, and we're going to be wiping in a motion like this, mainly because we've got two colors right next to each other, and we don't want to accidentally get red on the white or white on the red. So you don't need to drench the Q-tips in the non-acetone nail polish remover. If you do, you can end up getting drips into the different colors, and that we don't want that. So I'm going to be really cautious about how much I put on here. And we're just going to be doing a bit of this, working in one area first. And I'm going to be rotating the Q-tip quite often, because where we want the Q-tip to absorb as much of the excess paint as possible. And I'm using light strokes. You don't want to press down hard, because then you're going to end up digging into the paint that's in the roll marks. And as we get paint on the Q-tips, both ends of them, I'm just going to throw them away. You've got lots of Q-tips, so don't be afraid to use them. And this process may take you 10 minutes or so. I'm going to go ahead and continue doing exactly what you saw me doing here. I'm going to do that off camera, and we'll be back momentarily. Okay, you can see that we've made quite a bit of progress. We've got most of the excess paint off. And if you can see, there is a slight red hazing around some of the letters, and that is due to the blunt nature of these larger Q-tips. You really can't get in to do fine work with these larger Q-tips, and that brings me back to what we originally talked about with these other types of Q-tips for doing makeup, the Swiss burrs. These come in real handy for the final cleanup work. Because they have such precise tips, we can be really precise and we can clean right around the edges of the letters, like so. You can get in between the letters to a certain point. And having a magnifying glass or the magnifying glasses definitely helps. So patience is the key, and having the different applicators for doing the cleanup is also important. With these, we can get up really up close to the letters, a lot more precise than with the blunt head of the other Q-tips. So a lot of this depends upon how perfect you want this. I like to have it as perfect as possible, which means no excess red smudges around my letters. So I'm probably going to spend another 10 or 15 minutes working this area with these more precise Q-tips, and we'll be back to look at the final outcome. Okay, about another 15 minutes of cleanup. We've got our roll marks to this point right here. You can see that it's looking really good. It's still a little wet. One thing I want to stress is it is absolutely normal for you to end up with a little bit of color hazing around the edges of the letter. And that's mainly due to the fact that the finish on this lower receiver is a textured finish. So it's not completely flat. So there's going to be a little bit of color left over. Now there's two things that you can do. You can either say, okay, that's good enough, let this dry for another 24 to 48 hours before you put it together, or you can let it dry for another 24 hours and go back in and do another round of cleanup. And the reason I say let it dry for another 24 hours is that I've been working around this roll mark with the non-acetone nail polish remover, so the paint inside of the roll mark is really soft now, and it is prone to smearing if you're not careful once you get to this point. So the fine cleanup can be done again with the non-acetone nail polish remover and the fine-tipped Q-tips. Now another thing that you can do is you can use a small X-Acto knife like this, and you can use this to go around the outer edges of the letters and do a bit of scraping, because with the tip of this, I mean, you don't need to press hard because you don't want to scratch the surface of this. You want to just remove the paint residue. So you can go through and lightly scrape the areas where you can see the paint hazing. And then after you've gone through and you've touched it up with the X-Acto, then you can use your Q-tip and go over it again. So it's a multi-phase procedure if you want to get this perfect. I'm done with the red for right now. I'm going to let that dry, and I'm going to do a final touch-up. Before we move on to doing the white, I want to briefly talk about the Testors thinner that we mentioned before. This stuff is extremely dangerous to use for doing detailed cleanup of your roll marks. It can just basically destroy all the work that you've done. So if you are inclined and bold enough to want to use that, be very, very cautious with it. Use your fine-tipped Q-tips, dip the tip into it just a little bit, and be very, very careful with your cleanup. I can't stress that enough. I normally don't use the Testors thinner for doing cleanup work on the lower receiver because it's just too dangerous. You can end up ruining all this work that you've done. All right, so now that the red is more or less done, we're going to move on and we're going to do the white. Now the hazing that you end up with, that you get with the white, is a little bit more pronounced than the red. So I'm at a bad angle for doing this, but I'm going to try and do some of it on camera. These are light strokes, and of course I'm stroking away from the red. If I get any drips or smears of the paint, I don't want it anywhere close to the red. Now on the white paint, it's hard to tell when your Q-tip is getting filled up with white paint, so you have to keep an eye on that and rotate it, because you want to take paint off. You don't want to smear paint that's already on the Q-tip all over the lower receiver. And I am getting a bit of a smear down here. And that's pretty normal. Same thing happened with the red, but it wasn't as pronounced. And again, these are light strokes. You don't want to press down hard because we don't want to dig the Q-tip into the roll mark. And you know what? If you don't succeed with your first pass, take some of your testers thinner, take out all the paint, and do it again. The S is looking pretty good. So off camera, I'm going to do the rest of this, same procedure you saw me doing right here. We'll be back to take a look at it shortly. Okay, we've finished doing the safe roll mark, and you can see our results. Still a little wet, but I managed to get all of the white residue off of the lower receiver. I'm going to let this dry for 24 hours, and I'm going to go back in and do some final touch-up. For most people, this would probably be just fine, but I'm a bit of a perfectionist, so I like to get it as perfect as possible. Okay, after letting this sit overnight, it's ready for the final cleanup. You can see how far we've gotten to this point. The white looks really good. The red, we've got a little bit of hazing around the outer edges of it, and that's what I'm going to work on today. We're going to use the Testors thinner and our pointed Q-tips. And we're just going to be dipping the tip of the Q-tip into the thinner, and we're going to be working around the outer edges of the working around the outer edges of the lettering to clean up the hazing that's left over. Going to do the rest of this off camera and probably spend 15 minutes, 20 minutes or so on this, and we'll be back to take one final look. All right, our cleanup of the fire roll marks went as expected. I did manage to remove all the hazing around the edges of the letter without any issue. And that is going to end this video on how to color fill the roll marks on your AR-15 lower receiver.